Hello and welcome to this short overview presentation about light and shadows. The information in this presentation is shared as a supporting resource for students studying grade 4 science in Alberta, Canada. So what is light? Light is something that most of us take for granted, but stop and think for a moment. How would you classify light? Just what is it exactly? Well, light is a form of radiant energy. There are many kinds of radiant energy, from radio waves to gamma rays, but light is the form that we can see. Light travels in straight lines, and unlike sound, light doesn't need anything to travel through, like water or air, and can travel through the emptiness of space. If radiant energy couldn't do this, sunlight would never reach the Earth. This diagram shows sunlight traveling from the sun in a straight line. Although the sunlight is actually white, I've added colors to help keep things clear. The orange light beams at the bottom of the diagram show light traveling from the sun and through space, but not touching anything. It continues traveling in a straight line until it is either absorbed, reflected, or refracted. The yellow light beams show light that is traveling from the sun and is being absorbed and reflected from the Earth, which is a blue circle in this diagram. The white light beam shows beams that are traveling in straight lines from the sun and reflecting off of the moon, the small gray circle, allowing the moon to be visible from the Earth. But just how does light travel? Well, first of all, it travels really fast. Nothing travels faster than light. Light moves at 300,000 kilometers in 1 second. This is much faster than sound, and this explains why we see lightning before we hear thunder. When it comes to sources of light, there are two types, natural and man-made. The most important natural source of light is the sun. And energy from the sun provides us with the food that we eat, with our weather, and with warmth in our atmosphere. And the sun is just one of many, many stars, but because it is the closest star to the Earth, we get lots of energy from it. There are other forms of natural light, including lava that comes from volcanoes, which is so hot that it glows. Lightning is another form of natural light. Lightning is made up of particles in the air that become so hot that they create light energy. And certain animals, such as fireflies, jellyfish, and glowworms, make light through a chemical process known as bioluminescence. If we only relied on natural light, we wouldn't be able to live our lives the way we currently do. The first types of human-made light were campfires and oil lamps. Then the light bulb was invented by Thomas Edison in 1879. He put an electric current through a thin wire, which heated up and glowed, and this was the first incandescent bulb. Another type of bulb is a fluorescent bulb. This type of bulb sends electricity through a long tube filled with a special type of gas. These type of bulbs require less electricity than incandescent bulbs. Lasers are another type of artificial light. A laser is a very focused light beam that doesn't spread out or diffuse. Instead, a laser looks like a straight line. Lasers are used to cut metal or make cuts during surgery or read images on CDs and DVDs. Light does different things when it hits different surfaces. Clear materials like glass are called transparent. These items allow light to travel right through them. Items that allow only some light to travel through them, like wax paper, are called translucent. And items like brick walls or a textbook block all light and are called opaque. We only see things because light bounces off or reflects off of them. Light reflects off of an object at the same angle it hits it. If a surface is smooth, the reflection looks normal. The calm water in this picture creates a clear reflection of the mountain and the trees. However, if the surface is rough, the light reflects in many different directions. The surface of water here seems to sparkle because it is uneven and the light is reflecting in many different directions. Have a look at this picture. There's a lot going on. The light from the sun is reflecting off of the moon, and the reflected light bouncing off of the moon is reflecting and refracting off of the water. When light goes from one transparent material to another, like from air to water, it changes speeds and bends, and this is called refraction. Refraction is what causes the pencil in this example to appear broken. Light travels more slowly through water than it does through air. Refraction is also the reason that the chest in this diagram appears to be closer to the surface of the water than it actually is. Light has many colors, but sunlight is pure white. You can see the colors of light, though, by refracting them through a prism. The prism refracts and light separates its colors into a rainbow. Speaking of rainbows, rainbows occur when sunlight and rain combine in a very specific way. The beams of sunlight separate into the colors we see in the rainbow as they enter a raindrop. Because light can't travel through opaque objects, shadows are created. And in this diagram, the absence of light created by the light being absorbed into the opaque object, which is the man, creates a shadow behind the man. So in conclusion, we will be learning in this unit that light is radiant energy that we can see, that light always travels in a straight line, and light can travel through space, that light can be absorbed, reflected, or refracted when it strikes an object, and that the way light behaves allows us to see the world in the way that we do. As we begin this new topic of light and shadows, we will be conducting many interesting experiments to help us understand these concepts. Thanks for viewing. I hope you found this to be an interesting introduction to our topic.